Another bloody awakening for Afghanistan. Tuesday morning, a new explosion rocked eastern Kabul on the main road leading to Jalalabad. It's a route regularly used by international troops and a prime target for suicide bombers. This time, the attack claimed several lives and injured around 30 people, among them coalition forces and UN staff. Many of the civilian wounded were raced to nearby hospitals.
I was inside my shop and then it collapsed on me. So I walked away. There were a lot of dead bodies.
Several hours earlier, rockets fell around the presidential compound and police headquarters in the capital. No one was killed, but the three attacks have reinforced the sense of paranoia pervading Kabul 2 days before the elections begin.
Security? There isn't any. Election day is drawing closer and people are terrified.
15 million voters are eligible to cast their ballot on Thursday in presidential and provincial elections. Taliban insurgents see the vote as a deception instigated by the Americans. They have vowed to disrupt polling booths and called on Afghans to boycott the elections. If voters stay at home, it will undermine the legitimacy of the future president and further reinforce the instability plaguing the nation.